Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Galatians 4:21-26. Tell me, you who want to be under the law, are you not aware of what the law says? For it is written that Abraham had two sons, one by the slave woman and the other by the free woman. His son by the slave woman was born according to the flesh, but his son by the free woman was born as the result of a divine promise. These things are being taken figuratively. The women represent two covenants. One covenant is from Mount Sinai and bears children who are to be slaves. This is Hagar. Now Hagar stands for Mount Sinai in Arabia and corresponds to the present city of Jerusalem, because she is in slavery with her children, but the Jerusalem that is above is free, and she is our mother. Today's title is Born to be Free or Born to be Slave. I became a Christian when I was very young. As I look back on the time, that was a great time of revival. A lot of people got saved one way or the other. Most local churches were teeming with new believers every week. Testimonies of great miracles were heard constantly. Although most people were still in poverty, I could feel the apparent presence of hope and joy in many people. As an innocent boy, I thought to myself that all the people would eventually come to know the Lord in a few years. Unfortunately, my innocent dream as a boy hasn't come true yet. The era of great revival didn't last long. Some people refused to believe in the Lord tenaciously even through the great time of revival. A good portion of the people who came to know the Lord later backslide to either unbelief or to nominal faith. I feel so sad and somewhat angry about it. Why do some people want to be in bondage under sin when there is the free offer of salvation preached and proclaimed every day? I believe that's what Apostle Paul must have felt when he wrote today's passage. Tell me, you who want to be under the law, are you not aware of what the law says? For it is written that Abraham had two sons, one by the slave woman and the other by the free woman. His son by the slave woman was born according to the flesh, but his son by the free woman was born as the result of a divine promise. Apostle Paul passionately preached the gospel of freedom in Christ. He must have felt particularly stronger about the freedom of the gospel in Christ, for he himself was under the bondage of the law for such a long time. He now knew that he was a slave under the law and acted on flesh rather than on the free spirit of God. He finally figured out what the law truly meant. The law was meant to show us that we can't be saved by our own work but by the grace of God in Christ. But many people still chose to live under the law and its bondage. Why do people choose to live under bondage as if they were born to be slaves when they have a clear path to be born again free in Christ? How foolish and how sad. How about you? What path of life did you choose to follow? Do you still want to live under the law as if you are born to be a slave or under the freedom born of a free woman? The choice is yours.